How are you doing?
Yeah, I'm very well, thank you.
So
feeling fantastic.
Week and a bit, got the fight.
9 days.
Yeah?
Yeah.
How are you shaping up?
I'm shaping up absolutely fantastic. I've done 10 weeks of training camp, very hard, brutal. I'm in the best shape of my life.
Can you explain something for people who have no idea what you're talking about?
Okay.
There will be people who haven't heard it yet.
Yes.
You're a boxer.
I am,
A trained professional boxer.
Believe it or not.
But you are not fighting against a trained professional boxer.
Yes, yes.
Explain.
So this is a, you know, new wave in sport, you know, the crossover fights, you know, the YouTube boxing scene, you know, it's something that has just come alive in the past few years, to be honest. You know, I'm a traditional boxer, you know, as an amateur boxer, come up in the professionals, you know, had professional fights, and then all of a sudden they want me to fight these guys. And you know, I put two and two together in my head and I said, you want me to fight these guys who aren't even boxers? For a good amount of money, I said, no problem, sign me up. And that's that we're here today.
And you're fighting KSI?
I'm fighting KSI, yes.
Can I just ask, before you talk about KSI, is it safe for those non-professional boxers? And what kind of, you know, safety procedures, but kind of caveats are put in place?
Yeah, I mean...
Because you could have anyone who just says, I'm going to go and fight you because I want loads of paper, I want loads of money and I've got followers, but they could actually get really, really hurt.
No, that is really, really true. And... You know, at the end of the day, boxing is a risky sport.
Do you like KSI?
No.
Really?
Not one bit.
Ever? Have you ever liked
him? No. I've never been a fan. I just don't like the way, you know, he carries on. I'm not really about all this, you know, YouTube calling out people, you know, doing all this sneaky stuff.
And so do you let that come in to your mind when you're fighting him, or do you go into a different mode?
No, I'm in a different mode now. You know, I'm not really on social media. I've got a job to do, and that's to fight on October 14th. My job isn't to mess around on Instagram playing games, going back and forth with people. You know, That's what's generating the money, but at the end of the day, I'm not getting paid to do that. I'm getting paid to fight, and that's all I will be doing.
Can I ask you about Tyson?
Of course.
Will he be in your corner?
Tyson will be there on fight night, yeah.
He'll be there?
He'll be there, front and centre.
I mean, that's a serious presence to have, not only the advice, presumably.
Yeah.
Does he give you advice?
Yeah, of course he gives advice. He's in the locker room before the fight, you know, giving some instructions, saying what to do and what not to do, so it's amazing to have him there.
He's a character, Tyson.
I mean,
you know, he's your brother.
Yes.
You tell me, what's he like in those circumstances, just before a fight?
Yeah, amazing.
Has he been there before for you?
Yeah,
and what's
there.
That like in the room?
He was there just for the last one when I fought Jake Paul in Saudi Arabia. He's just a complete vibe by himself. You know, he's bubbly, he's chatty, he's fun, he's a great person to have.
So he's not hyping you up to get you more aggressive or anything?
Yeah, he is, at the end of the day, you can't enter the ring aggressive. If you enter the ring like, oh, God, I want to knock you out, you need to be calm and relaxed and have the game plan in mind. Because if somebody's all aggressive, they're not going to think about a game plan. They're just going to think about hitting you with shots. But if you've got a relaxed guy in the ring, right, this is a game plan, catch, a lot more relaxed.